Hello everyone, and welcome back to Markham's Isle in Thief 2 The Metal Age with Yost and Valid. So, you notice it might look a little different. Apparently, this is the other level where fog is a feature. So I decided I'd turn it on and take a look around. And you remember that gorgeous sunset that we had? Yeah, don't really have that anymore. Looking a lot more like a coastal island now. Far more mysterious and foreboding and dreary and wet. With all the rain and everything. I don't know, what do you guys think? Do you prefer this look for the island? Or do you prefer the other look? With it off, where we have this blazing sunset to look at, as well as the edge of the map. Because I don't think that was intentional. Because I love the mood that the darker... I love the mood that the darkness of the levels have. But for this level in particular, the last one I didn't like it so much, but for this level in particular, I really like how it looks with the fog. And I think that's something that's kind of interesting, actually, is just exploring that in of itself. Simply how one element, like fog, can completely change the aesthetic of a level. The aesthetic of everything, really. It sets the mood differently, it puts down... Ooh, creates a different atmosphere. It renders everything differently because now you have the fog that comes in and obscures distant things, which is what Silent Hill was so famous for. And they used to cover that. They used that to cover up the drawing limitations of the PlayStation 1. Which came out shortly before shortly before Thief 2 did, I think, actually. Because the original Silent Hill was 1999 on the PlayStation 1, I want to say. And it's still just... It's such a simple effect, but it's still so effective at eliciting a certain just emotion. But anyway, where we last left off, we had been wandering around Markham's Isle, banging in some heads and trying to not get spotted, knocking those people out by said child over there and by whoever the heck this is. So I could spend a whole lot of time messing around with this. I could also just leave. That is an option. And we also ran into one of Victoria's spies by the name of Lotus, who happened to be in cold storage over here and wanted nothing more than to be returned to the green, as he said. And in doing so, he gave us a peg. As a piece to a missing wheel, which I think was in this building, correct? There should be a way down here somewhere. I thought there was. Yes, here we go. So we got a huge old anchor. I'm not entirely sure what this is. Chart compass. Okay. And then, oh, a sextant. Okay, that's what they look like. All right. And then we have our wheel and our little round peg to go in it.
What the?
Oh no, I'm stuck in the floor. Are you serious? I'm actually stuck. I can't move. Oh no. What a great game. We're already off to a great start. I love it. Freaking love it. Garrett's what the was just so perfect for that. A little early, but it's fine. So in lieu of having better commentary for the game, I decided I would do some looking up. Just the name Markham in general is not a very common one anymore, and I thought I'd look into it a little bit.
What the?
I was hoping for something on Markham's Isle. Maybe there was some reference that the devs were making. But unfortunately, I found nothing. I couldn't find anything in the interviews. I couldn't find anything elsewhere online. We have a camera over there and a guard. So I just started looking up Markham, because why not? And I found some rather interesting things. Ooh. That I will get into in a moment.
Attention! Due to the recent mishap involving friend Ventus, I hath installed mine own invention of non-slip mats in the subaquatic outposts. These devices are full soft as carpet, yet also completely water-resistant. I promise thee, these mats should allow all mechanists to stand tall before Father Karras, and the Master Builder himself, friend Manus.
Interesting. Well, gotta do the regular thief thing of checking under the elevators. Which it looks like there is nothing. This is gonna be interesting. So it looks like that does a full rotation. We should be okay here. Yeah. Oh, getting stuck on edges. Yikes. Getting stuck on a lot of edges. Okay. So let's get you out of the way. You have different robes than the other friends that we've dealt with, than the other mechanists. That's interesting. And we still haven't found anything about Cavador. Because we were supposed to kidnap him and then return him to our rowboat, but we haven't found any information about Cavador. Not that I'm aware of, anyway. Because we talked to Lotus, but he didn't say anything about him. He just gave us the peg. And we still haven't found the long-lost pirate treasure either, have we? Well, considering this entire underground structure here, which does not look entirely done by the mechanists themselves.
That must be the Cetus Amicus. Guess I'll sneak aboard and have a look around.
Well, I don't think that they would have a term for this yet, but this straight up looks like a submarine. Doors open? Yes, but that thing is still on. Oop, got somebody coming up. Okay, he's doubling back. Ooh. Well, I misread that. Okay, now we go. Ooh, this is nerve-wracking. Okay, here we go. Now we got a nice dark spot. Phew. Okay. So we had a... So the ancient pirate... Well, maybe not so ancient, actually. But the pirate that used to make this his hideout was also named Markham.
Builder.
I'll let you go sleep in the corner, buddy. Again, I couldn't find any references to any pirates named Markham aside from the one in this game. So I just looked up the name Markham, and let's not get spotted by the child. But interestingly enough, the name Markham apparently means homestead on the boundary. Considering that this is an island out in the water, and many sailors might consider the ocean their home or the ship their home, homestead on the boundary between land and sea is quite an interesting one. Now, whether that linking was intentional at all, or the name just sounded cool, well... Oh, shoot. Ooh. Got a nice dark spot here. Gotcha. Okay. That line will never not bother me. That line will always, always bother me. I don't like that he's in the middle of the walkway, but we don't have much choice. Okay, so that's covered a little bit better. We'll drop a couple down here as well, just to be safe. That's a little sloppy with the spread, but what are you gonna do? Okay, that guy's just chilling. I don't see anybody there, so we'll put this guy out. Soft.
Twas a name.
So there's somebody beyond the area here. Okay. Well, where is he then? Ah, there you are. I should be able to sneak around, right? Yes. No problemo. Oh, lordy, hi! What the heck? Where did you come from? Did he see me through the door? Come on, let's go back up here. He must have seen me through the door, that's the only way- Whoa, you're really close, buddy. Come on.
How the unrighteous fall!
Come on. Can you not back yourself into a corner? Thank you. Missed me.
How the unrighteous fall!
Can you get knocked out, please? Whoa. God, this guy's so wiggly. There we go. Jeez. That was a little much. So did he see me through the vault door or something? I am very confused on how that happened. Alright, well let me drop him there. That was super weird. Yeah, I have no idea what happened. Yeah, they can see through the door. That seems like a bug. And I thought there was a fix for that in the patch I installed, but I guess not. That's really strange. Huh. Okay. Oh, would you looky here? Oh boy. Okay. Well, this is interesting, isn't it? He turned the other way. Damn it. Okay, no one's looking. Okay. And there is a door here as well. Oop. Oops. Whoopsie. All is quiet once more. Okay, well, how do I want to navigate this? That's all metal, jeez. Over here.
Just a boy.
There we go. Okay. Well, that's that taken care of. Yeah, that threw me off my rhythm a little bit. First coming into this area where we have the hole and everything. God, they have an entire underground structure here. Or underwater structure, I mean. I think I'll head back there in a minute. I want to see where the different vault doors lead to. As stupid as it might be, considering that there are people there. If someone is there, then show thyself. Yeah. So, he's not looking this way. Is it worth this? I should have quick saved it, whatever. Okay.
Is that thou, friend?
Wait. This is carpet, isn't it?
Were leaves in mine ears.
Yep, this is carpet.
But they're gone now.
That's carpet. I wasted those moss arrows. I should have used one here. That's a little better.
And behold,
A man will come unto thee, and he will be a leader of men, and he will be a wager of war, and he will be a shedder of sap, and he will be a spiller of blood.
That's an interesting line.
For Karis.
Okay, I think you're good right there. At least for the time being. Just double check here, make sure there's no one inside this room that would hear us. Does not look to be the case. What is this? In time of peril, breaketh glass. Looks like a breath potion and a health potion.
Friend Erlen, thou art hereby tasked with retrieving Father Karras' belongings from the flooded living area near subaquatic outpost number 1. Of prime importance is his work in progress, the new scripture of the Master Builder. Retrieve it at once, and the Builder will surely bless thee. Helissa. Helissa.
I love that name. Okay, so there's a flooded area where Karras' most recent scripture, or one of them, has been lost. And yes, I did just flash myself like an idiot. Okay, well. What did that even do? That's what it does, it opens that door, okay. Well, we'll just leave that open then. Don't care about it too much. And here's the rotting wood. Peekaboo? No? Okay.
Captain, today we did run through that scurvy lighthouse keeper. We tried to reason with him, but whine he did like a crippled dog. Talk he did of his fair miss, who be scheduled to return to the cove. When she arrives, I be sure to turn her over to ye. We also know of some loot he did hide. We be keeping ye informed. Ye should also know that the crew wishes to rename the cove after you. 'Tis a proud day indeed for the Brotherhood of the Sea. Thomas.
Oh dear, so maybe not so, Oop. Maybe this did not happen so long ago.
Who's there? What noise dost make?
Okay, so you're not there. What about in here? Hello? 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 Ooh. Yikes. Well, that's a little sketchy. Well, I guess he doesn't see me from here, so that's good. Gotcha. Oh, and we have keys. 1, 2, 3, and 4, huh? Cargo locker keys. Interesting. So we're missing the 5th cargo locker key. And we also don't know where the hell the other cargo locks are. Let's put this torch out while we're at it. And we have yet another archer. How fast does that camera turn around? You coming through? Yes, you are. Perfect. Thank you kindly. Put this out as well. Since we work better under cover of darkness. Not that it helped a whole lot. Okay, and then we head over this way. Nothing there. Hmm. Got an old pirate shanty. Subaquatic post 2. Post 1. Oh, that was the main pirate base? Really? Interesting. Okay, then the pressure door controls that open both of these areas. And we still haven't gone through the cargo stacking area up this way. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and double back then. Let's quick save. Didn't mean to drink the breath potion, but okay. I'm actually gonna reload that, just in case. Using stock sound effects from the 90s. Did anyone else have that, it was this little tiny free download that you could get, where you basically clicked on it and it would take an image of your desktop, and you could pick from a whole bunch of different weapons and just blast the hell out of whatever you had on the screen. Like, I think there was a saw, there was a flamethrower, there were ants, there was a stamp, there was a machine gun, there was just a whole bunch of stuff. And you could just deform your desktop at will. And it was so much fun, and it was so stupid and simple. Does anyone remember that? Or is that just a 90s kid thing? I have to not be the only one that remembers that. Okay, this just leads here. Yeah, okay. So this leads to the main room, and I'm assuming this would lead there too. Okay, so let's double back. This away. The only reason I even remember that is because I think there was a hammer tool in that, where you could hit the, this is different. I'll be a little bit more careful with this, I guess. But you could hit the first few hits that you would do in a spot, it would make a glass breaking sound effect. Which is kind of the only reason I bring it up. I haven't thought about that in years. Oh, I hate this. So I think that might just be a door control? But I'm not entirely sure. Okay, so we have carpet here. Let's throw that down to one. Let's throw one down there. I'm thinking it may have all just bounced off my feet right there, which is kind of unfortunate. Whoa! Yeah, that's just a gate control. Okay. We don't have a way to turn the lights off here, do we? Have somebody in there. Are these beds or are these shelves? They're solid metal, so I'm assuming they would be shelves, but there's bedding on them. Or I mean, they could put bedding on them. Watcher control. Bingo. Gotcha. Okay, turn that off. Okay, so now I can wander around here at our leisure. Nice, very nice. Oh. Are these diving helmets? That's kind of what they look like. What's the... Interesting. Not sure what that trapdoor is for. Attention, subaquatic crewmen. Master Karras hath learned that the previous occupants of these caves left behind a most great quantity of wealth upon their departure. The local legend hath it that the leader of the pirates, Captain Markham, didst hide a sea chest of treasure somewhere neath the surface. The myth doth also state that this bounty be kept in a structure like a sailing vessel. All subaquatic crewmen should consider themselves tasked to find this gold for the good of the Mechanist Order. Okay, so we have a better hint as to where Markham's treasure would be. But would this lead down to it? I don't know. This I do not know. Oh! Well, there you go. Looks like we found it. Also... So there's a dead diver and there's a skeleton at the helm. Well, that's never a promising sign. I want to check down here really quick. Got a floating bottle. Is that everything in here? Looks like it might be. Alright. I probably missed something, but, you know.
Yo ho ho and a bottle of rum.
Fucking. Okay. Well, either we got a spirit haunting this place, or we got some very well laid traps. Oh. That's a not great way to die.
If ye be reading this note, ye likely be here for the bounty of the good ship Catherine's Folly, the same as the fool before ye. Ye best be turning back now and stay out of me vessel's hold, for ye suffer the same fate as he, Captain Markham.
Okay, well. We would not be a good thief if we didn't ignore the warnings and try to break in anyway. Oh my. There is a lot of stuff here, huh? And we can't swing because we're underwater. Right. So why would Markham hide his chest underwater? That's what I'm curious about. Oh. Okay. Nope. Can't catch me, boyo. Whee! Huh. So is... So I'm a little confused as to the timeline. I'm not sure why there's a cursed pirate there. Why there's a ghost of a pirate? Is that Captain Markham himself? Or is that some scallywag spirit that he's... somehow gotten to haunt his treasure? Because I'm... This is supposed to be an old pirate base, right? But based on some of the dialogue, it almost sounds like it's still going on? So is Markham dead, or... what? Very confusing. I'm gonna take a sip of my tea. I remember growing up, sometimes when you get the milk and spices, especially if it had turmeric in it, people would call it chai tea. Apparently chai just means tea. So if you're calling something chai tea, it's just tea tea. It's a little redundant, and I've met some people more recently who have pointed that out and get a little bit stuck up about it when people say chai tea. It's like,
come into the light so that I might see thee.
It's you're calling it chai. It's tea. But it has milk in it, and it has certain spices in it, right? So it's... so that should denote that it's a certain type of tea. So they call it chai tea. But that's not how it works. It's just that different people make tea differently. Close? There we go. Okay, we got some money. And some people heading in here. Articles of the good ship Catherine's Folly, as set forth by Captain Dark William Markham. Every man shall obey civil command. The captain shall have one full share and a half in all prizes. The master, carpenter, and boatswain shall have one share and quarter. If any man shall offer to run away or keep any secret from the company, he shall be marooned with one bottle of rum, one bottle of water, one cutlass. If any man shall steal any thing in the company, or gamble to the value of a piece of gold, he shall be marooned or shot. If at any time we should meet another marooner, that is, pirate, that man that shall sign his articles without the consent of our company shall suffer such punishment as the captain and company shall think fit. That man that shall strike another whilst these articles are in force shall receive Ludman's Law, that is, 40 stripes, lacking one, on the bare back. That man that shall snap his arms or carry a candle lighted without a lanthorn shall suffer the same punishment as in the former article. Because you don't want to be setting ships on fire, that's for sure. That man that shall not keep his glade clean, fit for an engagement, or neglect his business shall be cut off from his share and suffer such other punishment as the captain and the company shall think fit. If any man shall lose a joint in time of an engagement, he shall have 400 pieces of gold, if a limb, 800. If at any time you meet with a prudent woman, that man that offers to meddle with her without her consent shall suffer present death. Markham's not messing around. Dang, okay. So basically, if I'm to understand what business is supposed to be, keep relatively hygienic, keep your tools clean, don't mess with people outside of the group, specifically people that have been marooned, don't hit each other, don't endanger the people on the ship, especially by carrying around fire or firing off a weapon. And don't abandon your post or steal. And you get compensation for accidents or for combat, whatever. And if you don't treat women well, you are put to death. I like that. Margum didn't mess around. And that's kind of one of the funny things, because in a lot of... It depended on crew to crew, right? But by the very nature of such a harsh lifestyle as piracy, a lot of the governance, at least from what I've read up on, is surprisingly democratic. It's less about the captain being this overbearing force of nature, and more about just reasonable engagement between all of the members of the crew. And you kind of had to have that. Piracy was a really hard life. Anything at sea is a really hard life. And in order to keep the peace in a way, you had to have somebody that kind of oversaw the general rules, but those rules were agreed on by the majority of the crew. It wasn't just random crap that the captain came up with. And you don't want to be, if you are going to be a captain that's going to be overbearing and cruel, you had to be pretty damn strong, because otherwise you're going to have a crew that's just going to throw you off the boat. No questions asked. And I don't know how I want to handle this.
All is quiet once more. Thanks be to Karras.
So does he double back? Yeah, he doubles back. Well, I'm gonna try and go for it now.
What noise?
Nope. Oop, don't. Get down. There we go.
The wind plays all silty and unholy rot. Surely that's all it was.
Okay. And can I get two birds with one stone here? Nice. Perfect, perfect. Can I get up the stairs, please, game? There we go. Jeez. Okay, neither of you have anything on you. So I'll just toss you down the stairwell really quick. Cool. Alright. So yeah. There's your fun fact about pirates for the video. I think that's all carpeted. Is this carpeted? Yes, it is. Cool. Okay, there is somebody coming up. At least I think there is. Because I know I saw another face around here. Yeah, here we go. Well, that was a little close. And peek. Anybody? No, I think that's everybody here. So what's down here then? Okay. So, what's this way then? God, I hate how loud this is. Oh, this is the changing room, I guess. Can I pick up the other flash bomb, please, instead of flashing myself? It's so annoying. Yep, we got a bedroll in there. Looks like we got a diver's helm. Yeah, I got a diving helmet. Alright. A few flares that I don't care about. Some money. And I guess that's it? Oh no, we do have something.
Well, Rick, indeed, Father Karras's plan proves yet more brilliant than I hath imagined. The Father doth call it the Cetus Project, after the Cetus Amicus. The project itself, however, is in truth the grand meshing of several operations, like two gears joining their cogs. At the KD site, Cavador hath uncovered the ancient power used by our order to benefit all of humankind.
Ancient power, you say?
Our vessel must needs transport those discoveries back here to Markham's Isle. Even the restoration of the lighthouse was directed by Karras himself. When the Cetus Amicus returns from a journey to the KD site, the lighthouse beacon is used to signal Karras and Angel Watch. Everything doth prove so machine-like, so perfect.
Friend Loris. Interesting. That is very interesting. We got another key. Ah, there's our cargo locker 5. So why would that be locked in? Why would that be down here? That's really strange. Was somebody just a bumbling idiot and dropped it down in there, or what? And I believe they also said something about... Karras's scripture? We haven't passed the old pirate shanty yet, so... Cliffface old house... We haven't really inspected the well, I don't think. So maybe it'd be worth going back there really, really quickly to just check it out? Yeah, I might do that before we explore further down here. So, I will see you guys in a moment. That elevator has a lot of force, huh? Not me shitting my pants. Jeez. That was a lot more terrifying than it should have been. Okay. Well, at least we can inspect this well in peace now. There is a lever on it. But not one that we can interact with. We can, however, climb down. Really? Alright, well, glad we got a health potion at least. If I can find it through the million keys I have. So, what's down here then, I wonder? Oh, we got a whole cave system going on down here. Would you look at that? Is that a person? No, it's a machine. Okay. And you're a watcher that's been turned off. Ugh. Well, I'm assuming he would alert if something happened. God, anytime I see something like this, it just terrifies the hell out of me.
Friend Gorik, please make thou haste in repairing this child that treacherous pagan didst harm it most grievously. But fear not that any more of thy companions will be harmed, for the saboteur has been subdued. Friend Pendulous.
Okay, so I'm guessing that this guy's busted then. Which is nice. Oh, this is right out here. Well, what do you know? Small world after all, huh? So is that the only note around here, or is there something that we can grab or loot or something?
An error. An error. Fails to understand. Creation.
I hate it so goddamn much. I hate it. 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 Yep, I'm just going. I hate everything about it. Brings up those far-reaching questions about what really is life and consciousness and all that Soma explored quite well.
If someone be there, then bespeak thyself.
I would love to play that game at some point on the channel.
Silence visits me again.
We are running a little bit low on moss arrows, which is a bit concerning. Wow, that worked out. Cool. Another breath potion and a couple flash bombs. I don't necessarily think that was worth the expenditure, but we'll stick with it. Okay, well, at least we figured out what's beyond the well, and we got a few more things, so I guess we'll head back down. There we go. When you have the logic switches set to one animation versus another instead of... instead of just having values set to whether it's on or off. Not good, not good, not good, not good. Damn it. Down we go again! And quick save, because I do not want to go through that again. There we go, much better. Okay, now we're back here. And by back here, I mean through the second door, because this is the last area that I don't think we've explored yet. Past the old pirate shanty. Okay, so that leads over there, but we still have this little area to explore. And we also have under the boards, where there may potentially be something. Ooh.
What shadow passed my view? All is quiet once more, thanks be to Karras.
Okay, do I really want to wait for him to stand around? How many flash bombs do I have? I have 5 flash bombs, I can waste one. Yeah.
The light so that I might see thee.
Doink. And this is locked, huh? Not for long. Okay, maybe for a while, but it's still not gonna be locked for too long. Cool. And we still want to find that scripture, so... Rust gas container. Interesting. And a mechanism ace. So we can use this rust gas container. Huh. Some money. I'm gonna find those lockpicks again. And we have a little statue. Okay, was there anything down here? Doesn't appear to be the case. Though it's kind of hard to tell in the darkness. Which I suppose is the point. Wrong arrow. So, we have a lot of vine arrows, but I was expecting there to be a bit more climbing. Which has not really been the case. And I can't imagine that we'd be using it on the Cetus Amicus, which I'm assuming is the name of the submarine. So I don't know. Ooh, don't get stuck. Okay. Yeah, so this is gonna lead to the submarine. I think we can just get up here from the inside, but yeah. Yeah, let's go back and figure that out as well. Okay, we're back here. And I'm curious if there's anything under the water. We haven't gone that away quite yet, but I want to explore down here first. No, it's just some rocks. So one thing I've noticed about some of the boulders here is that some of them have, they'll have little specks in them, little glinty bits. So I'm wondering, is that potentially silver? And what the heck are these, drilling machines? Looks like we got a few mines. So I guess that's another diving room of sorts? But why would it be separated from the rest of this place? That's really strange. Well, now that I think about it, these arrows might actually come in handy for speedruns and the like if you're trying to get through this, or for ghosting. If you're trying to get through this without knocking anyone out or just trying to have a few shortcuts here and there. And there are some beams. So maybe there's some treasure hidden up here? Maybe, possibly, hopefully? I don't see anything here, but I definitely think I see something over there. Yeah, is that a little nugget? That might be a little nugget. Alright, well, down we go. And... we climb up this, and that gives us a shortcut over there. Assuming that this is actually going to be high enough for me to vault on. Can I... Oh my god. That's a pain in the ass. Alright, let's try this again. Did that hit the beam, or did that hit the... I'm going to assume it hit the beam. It looks like it hit the beam. Okay. Oh wow, that was barely on the edge. Yeah, that is a silver nugget. Cool. Alright. Oop. That's a little risky, isn't it? Jeez. Alright, well now we can get up and actually explore where that one tunnel leads. Because we have not been that way yet. Jeez, they got a whole ventilation system and everything down here too. Oh! Is this the flooded area they were talking about? It sure seems like. There's a whole bed and everything here. Huh. So, where? I love how you can mount stuff in it on the water. A little ridiculous. So I don't see anything here that's usable. Maybe it's further down? Oh dear. Do we have... There it is. I don't know what it said. We're definitely gonna need that breath potion, though.
The new scripture of the Master Builder, draft page 16. Charis saw that a person, an animal, a plant, anything ill-born of nature, when consumed by the gaseous necrotic mutox, would dissolve into rust. Charis had observed this many times, over and over again, for in it he felt the presence of truth. Whether released by a container or through the lips of a servant's mask, Charis would observe the action of the gas from a spot as close to the area of effect as he possibly could in safety. When the rust settled, Charis would zealously scrutinize the remains for meaning. And now Charis looked back upon those investigations, and he spoke aloud, saying, "O Master Builder, I have felt your will. I know that I have been chosen to bring your paradise to the world. I know that I must not fail, or your wrath shall consume me, and I shall lie forever in the forest you have saved for those who are unholy. Master Builder, my mind shall be sharp, my machines will not falter, and I will keep Charis from the risk of death. In your name, I shall construct a protective chamber in Soforth Cathedral, and there, where I cannot be harmed, Charis shall stay. I shall reconsider every element of my plan. If any are weak, Charis shall make them sound."
Well, now we know where to find Charis. Soulforge Cathedral. Huh. Interesting. Okay. Well, we need to get out of here before we drown. And let me see if I can find that breath potion really quick. Here we go. You could probably make that without too much trouble, in all honesty, if you knew what you were doing. But those breath potions are really helpful. Okay, well, that's the last scripture that we needed. And now, we can get the hell out of here and head up to the Cetus Amicus, I suppose. And fall all the way down. Okay, so we have a variety of ways we can tackle this. But what's the best option? Are they in diving suits? They are. Okay. Well, then the question becomes, can we even knock them out with the gas arrows? And I'm also a little bit low on health, so let me use that. Can you just patrol that away? Okay. Oh, this is all metal, yikes. If we can make it to darkness safely? Well, it's not really darkness, but... Really, game? God, I hate that about this physics engine. It'll just randomly... be a pain in the butt. Why you gotta do that, game? Come on. The jank of old, physics systems. Well, let's try from afar, I suppose. Oh, nope, we're good. Get the arrow out. There we go. And run for it. Perfect.
Is that thou? By Karras, a weed!
Are you serious? Well, that's annoying. Let's get closer there, then. What was that? Why did I just launch? Okay, there we go. That should be better. Send me back. Alright, and this time instead of waiting.
I have no mischief on my watch.
Oh dear. Oop, I am stuck.
Was just a moss in my eye.
Oh boy. Well, we made it in somehow. And for some reason, this is all made of stone. Which I guess I won't complain about too much, considering that it's significantly quieter than the steel. So it looks like we have some sleeping quarters. A little money purse. You know how heavy this thing would have to have stone floors? Jeez. Let's see, a captain's log, huh? Jeez, these are some long entries. Captain's log, Cetus Amicus, entry 1. Today was indeed a fine day, for Karras was on hand for the commissioning of this, the finest of vessels, the Cetus Amicus. Drink some tea to keep the throat going. In all my years as captain of seagoing craft, I have never sailed a ship so sleek or strong. Verily, the Cetus Amicus mocks those wave-bound barges. To glide below the flotsam and jetsam, to stand safely in the womb of this steel shark as she cuts through the briny deep. Never again shall there be a vessel as fine as this. Entry 26. Damn that Freitas! He has failed miserably in his duties as cargo master, and will be disciplined forthwith. To lose the only key to Cargo Locker 5, he claims he passed it to Senwith while in Subaquatic Outpost 1, but the key has since disappeared. I fear it may have slipped beneath the flooring into the bilge water. Until one of the men can locate the key, Cargo Locker 5 remains sealed. Entry 30. Fish again. If only mutton would keep on our voyages. Entry 31. Today, we set course once again for the KD site, bringing Cavador back to continue his excavation. He wouldn't go into details, but apparently he's uncovered some new artifact that Karras is very excited about. This may be the last voyage we make in quite some time, as Cavador has been ordered to remain at the site indefinitely. Oh. Okay. Entry 39. The crew is prepared for yet another voyage to the KD site, this time to drop off special cargo for Cavador. He's ready to excavate another zone, and, as per standard mechanist procedure, needs to cleanse the area with rust gas to prevent the growth of any flora. I must admit, however, that I have grown tired of these mundane cargo runs. I feel the time has come to refit the Cetus Amicus as a ship of war, and venture beyond the confines of established routes. I shall propose this change to my superiors upon my return from the KD site. So I'm assuming that gives us the information that we need in order to find out where what's-his-face is? Yeah, because we can't kidnap Cavador, but we know where he is now. Steal a sample of the rust gas to bring back to Victoria. Oh. Okay. Well, we did that already. Don't kill any mechanists. We've done everything else, stowaway in the Cetus Amicus and Cargo Locker 5, because they don't have access to it, makes sense. It's time to hitch a ride and see what Cavador's up to. Cool. Oh. Well, may as well snatch some food, I suppose. Get somebody else in trouble. So considering Karras has been expecting us, is he going to be expecting us to hop onto this as well? Can I please just not... I want to look at the apples. There we go. Now we have some munchies that we can deal with. Anything here behind this... No. Now that's an interesting detail I never noticed before, because I'm assuming this is of Karras, correct? So he's got the helm. He's got the chest plate. But look at his hand. Is that just more of a glove, or have his fingers been replaced? And what the heck is going on with all of that right there? Some very odd and slightly concerning details. It almost makes it look, not really Geiger-esque, but it has a few of those same elements, you know what I mean? I got some fish hanging out here, huh? What? Okay! I didn't mean to pick up his body, but whatever. I'll take the water arrows, at least. Okay, so it does open that. So these are just stowing tools, I suppose. Is there gonna be anybody here? It's gonna be a nice gold vase for some reason. Nothing there.
Okay. Thou art new to the movement, friend.
Tis the truth. Time passed, I served them. But my heart could no longer bear to see such hard times befall them, and such little spirit to carry on them. And tis clear to see that it profits little to be a hammer in these times.
Aye, many hath come in such a while. Tis not a hard task to see that we are the future.
Thou wert not with the Order of the Hammer before?
Nay. Those brothers were always too stern and righteous for my choice. And they turned their faces away from our Lord Karras when he spoke of progress. When I heard of the great works he had made since he left them, I came.
Hammer, I was all forced to withstand the silent scorn of the masses. But the garb of a mechanist carries much prestige with it.
So more about the hammers being very strict and not very well liked. The mechanists, on the other hand. The mechanists, on the other hand, are, I guess, liked by a lot of people? Which is an interesting little story there. A couple scouting orbs. Another book. Cetus Amicus Cargo Manifest. Main hold supplies for Katie's site. Cargo locker 1 weaponry, 2 is potions. 3 rust gas if moved from main cargo storage, which it wasn't yet. 4 scouting orbs, and then 5 is miscellaneous equipment that they don't have access to because somebody lost the key, like an idiot. Okay, and then this is fueled by fire. Just a good old steam engine. Oh, you could come up from the bottom the whole time. That would have been easier. Anything special out here? No. So this is the really long hallway that runs... Okay. Cool, that's good to know. So if we had wanted, we could have gone along here the whole time instead of having to deal with the guy up top. I'll just reload that. Well, at least we know that now. And once again, these are switches that we can't mess around with. Okay, well, I think that is that. So let's get out of here. Become a stowaway. Miscellaneous indeed. We have a sample of the rust gas, though, don't we? Wait, I thought... Oh, I didn't. Because that was before the... Because I died. Alright, well, I'll go pick it up, and then I'll see you guys back here, I guess. Blech. I need to remember where the hell it is. where you are. Living quarters, pirate treasure. Pirate shanty, maybe. Because I don't think... Forgot to do this part. Okay.
Come into the light so that I might see thee.
All right. Nicely used mine. Okay, there's the gas. And now we get some money. And we're done. Okay, now we can rest easy and get the hell out of here.
I hope it's a short ride.
I wanted to lock the door, damn it. Jeez, okay. Well, once again, things have become more complicated than they would first appear. Oh, man. This is going to be interesting to figure out what artifact they found. And... what the heck has been going on? Because there was that whole system with Cavador finding stuff, and then the lighthouse signaling Karis, and just... and we now we know where Karis is hiding out, and we have another piece of scripture. It's a whole bunch of stuff. But that is going to have to wait until the next episode. So until then, thank you guys so much for watching. It's getting into November. If you're in the Southern Hemisphere, I know it's getting kind of warm, finally. If you're up north like I am, it's starting to get cold. Days are getting shorter. So stay warm. Some places have already gotten a lot of snow. So. But take care, everybody, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.